You shall not take vengeance, nor bear any grudge against the children of your people, but you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Leviticus 19:18. Good morning, Lord our God, our hope and our firm foundation we may stand on. Hallowed be, and holy is your name. Thank you, Lord, for your holy word, for the wisdom of heaven passed down to us through scriptures. You are full of love and mercy that you would do all that you have done to draw our hearts back to you and to help us stay in and under your care. We have no excuse when we stand before you, for you have made the way for us to come back into a loving relationship to you. I have your word, I have Jesus, and I have your Holy Spirit, so that I may walk in holiness and grace all my days. Thank you. I ask your anointing on these scriptures as I ponder on them this morning, that I may learn and grow in love. In your name I ask this, Jesus, amen. Lord, my word for this year is love, as you know. And love can and does grow cold between people and between us, and you sadly too, because in Revelation you talked about coming back to our first love. I am reminded of how it feels when we are in love at first. I am reminded of how we long to be with the one we love. I am thinking about that lately, watching our granddaughter who is engaged with her young man. Remembering how Jerry and I were and how we wanted to be with each other all the time like those two do, to the exclusion of all others, even close family. It is like they only see each other. That is the love you have for us, and you desire us to love you that way. Our love for you taking first place before all others. You even say that we are not to love mother or father, children, more than we love you. I can see this more now as I have grown older. You desire first place in our hearts, and second place will not do. You have made us first place after all, sacrificing Jesus for us. Here you handle us with wisdom, cause you know exactly how we are in our fallen nature, with wanting to hurt others or get even when they have hurt or abused us. That tends to be our first thought, make them pay for what they did to us. But you tell us that it is your place to take revenge if it is necessary. We are not to even bear a mental grudge against them, even if we do not take action on our attitudes. And I see why you tell us that, because it only hurts us and Satan uses it to destroy our peace and rest in you, replaying the injustices we perceive that have been done us. It really does ruin our love walk with other people, then it can build a wall in our love walk with you too. We are to let go of all our offenses and not let them take root in our hearts and bear bitter fruit. Especially those in the family of God. Lord, I don't think we can love others as you will without you, your Spirit living in us and teaching us how to love others. Our sin nature is too selfish to love sacrificially and with full submission to others. You tell us to love them, treat them just as we ourselves would want to be treated. But I think that even telling us to love them or treat them like we want to be treated is not all that you desire, but Lord, I think you want no selfish motives or doing it because we have to, but because we actually want good for others to the expense of our own selves, with no expectation of repaying us. We are to put others before our own wills and wants. Putting others' good above our own comforts and desires is godly. It is your way and is pure and from the Spirit and not out of our flesh. Lord, one more time I see that I need you so, that I cannot love you or others without you in me, in my heart. Lord, I confess that I may be able to do this by my will a little, but I cannot live and love others by my own will for very long, or from my heart, if you are not in my spirit leading me and helping me to be loving and compassionate like you with others. My success depends on my relationship with you to walk out these words written here. Lord, I need your Spirit and your fullness operating in me. My Lord, thank you for these scriptures this day. Thank you for reminding me to be more selfless and more loving to all around me. Lord, thank you for working in my heart to teach me to love others more as I learn to love you more. Lord, please watch over and protect all our loved ones from evil and harm. Please set watch over Jerry and I. Please guard and watch over our hearts, Lord. Please forgive me for my remaining hardness of heart and make me more like you in my compassion and grace towards others. I ask your grace and help in your holy name, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Amen.